Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And recently I played with a T71 die, and I can tell you one thing, this tank is a hidden gem, and literally hidden gem. Where you are finding this vehicle, you might ask. Well, answer is quite simple. You are finding it in collection vehicles in American Tech 3, and it is a T71 die. It is pretty much like Tech 3 version, aka T71 CMCD, but with auto loader. And this is a beautiful tank to play with. I had a blast, and I truly enjoyed myself to the maximum. We finished this vehicle in 101 games, if I'm not mistaken. Uno momento, let me find it. Yep, 101 games with 1,700 average damage, 1,200 assisting damage, and we got ourselves a solid 100% of mark of excellence. And I truly want to say I had a blast while playing with this vehicle, and it was truly enjoyable. And now I want to share my happiness with you, and we are going to see three battles. Two of the first games are going to be for a damage, obviously, and the third battle is going to be the best assisting damage we had, and we will do some commentary on it, and it is going to be very, very hard game. Anyways, without further ado, let's teleport into the action, shall we? And we are back, fellas. The very first battle which we are having is going to be in Kempinovka field, because this map is just simply ideal for any light tank. But how we are going to do the things, fellas? We are not going to go for pure spotting, you know, sitting in the bush and doing nothing. No, we are going to focus obviously for spotting and for doing damage in the same time if it is possible. And how do I like to start my battle? I truly love to start my battle from, especially when I'm playing from the south spawn, I like to take this position here. From here we can be extremely flexible, we can spot enemies, and we can do many, many bad things, obviously by spotting them and by doing damage. And this is going to be extremely important start, and you need to keep attention at this and pay attention at this. So yeah. How the things are looking like, we are getting spotted instantly, and now the question is, we are getting spotted by Vaka or we are getting spotted by MX1375? And there is a way how to check the things out. You need to wait 10 seconds and then move backwards or frontally, doesn't really matter, and to see are you getting spotted. Because if you are getting spotted, that means enemy light tank is sitting over there, and if enemy tank is sitting over there, he is going to have a very bad time. And in this kind of situation, I believe it is proving my point, and we pretty much beat the living crap out of this gentleman, and he made a mistake. He thought he's outspotted, and obviously clearly he wasn't, and we managed to clip him out pretty damn well. We have some blind shots and everything. By the way, this battle is the best damage dealt with this tank, but I can tell you one thing, fellas, we had plenty, I repeat, plenty games where we had 3000 damage plus like nothing. I truly did not want to take one for the team from the VK, but unfortunately I did, and I cannot change absolutely anything about this. A bit of the greediness worked in his favor, but it is how it is. I'm paying a humongous attention at the max map whenever I am playing the game, so what am I waiting? I am waiting until I will reload, and obviously we can clip out the shitter. That's all we needed to do, and now we can start working on the VK or any other heavy tanks who are trying to make a humongous pressure on the hill, right? Easy peasy, just like this. So once again, we have four in the magazine. There is no way for there is no need for us to panic, and we can actually try to take the main spotting bush. And we are in the bush now, so outplaying us from this position is a big pain in the ass for enemies. And honestly, how you sometimes can outspot someone here if you are playing light tank and you are doing some scouting runs like this, or you are actually pushing like this or pushing like this. It is pretty much only one way how you are outspotting the person who is sitting in this bush. Obviously, you can go with a blind shot and blind shots are actually very, very valuable strategy and everything, but in the same time, it is not so easy as I would love to say. Anyways, after the very first shot, I noticed I'm not getting spotted, so I am feeling a bit confused because I thought Challenger is definitely going to spot us, but as you can see, it is not the case. And that's completely fine. All we need to do, we need to return to the same bush, and now we are going to start farming person who is playing on top of the hill and who is not 100% safe. And that's what I love about the light tanks overall and auto loader light tanks. By the way, French lights are my favorites. I'm speaking about the 3090 line or 13105 line, however you would call this. And I have absolute blast while playing with them. And now look at this. We are getting tracking shot. And at this point, I know last time the Challenger did not outspot us. What that basically means? That basically means he is not going to spot us this time, more likely. Also, if you would pay attention at assisting damage, we have 666, so we have Pyrosami assisting damage. And fellas, skill! What did that flying F is Pyrosami? Fellas, he's our he is our devil of the stream, okay? He deserved this title for wishing us all the best. By saying all the best, I mean to get penetrated by the Arta and so on, so on. So he is a devil, fellas. And there is nothing to add and there is nothing to say. Meanwhile, we're just sitting in the typical bush here. Well, not so typical bush, but you can get a lot of use. I am using this position to outspot everyone who is playing in the Delta 2 or Delta Delta 3, right next to this stone. And everything is looking pretty damn well. We have 2200 damage, we have 800 assisting damage, which is always nice and always welcome, but there is still quite a bit of stuff for us to do. And I'm thinking, am I going to spot them or not? And I noticed our guys won the hill, so at this point I really want to make quite a bit of pressure, fellas. I truly want to do that. And as you can see, I am hesitating. I want to go in front, I don't want to go in front, I want to go in front, I don't want to go. Okay, I'm going. So from this side angle, there is a huge chance we are going to spot enemy Artas, or we are going to spot the Super Hellcat. And as you can see, enemy Arta is spotted. That's good. We are smacking him once, we are smacking him twice. Unfortunately, we are getting spotted ourselves. This is quite greedy from my side, but I am not complaining too much. And in fact, I am feeling completely fine. We are going on the reload, and whenever we are going to finish reloading, obviously, we are going to have a great position to simply eliminate the Super Hellcat and Tiger 1. And everything is looking just great. We are getting plenty of assisting damage, and now we are working on this one-shottable Super Hellcat. He is dead, and all we need to do now, we need to make sure we are going to eliminate both clickers from the game. Although, if I remember this correctly, I think people who are working off World of Warships, they introduced Arta in the game in World of Tanks as well, because of the extra feature Aka being submarine. And speaking about the submarines, he is a Russian submarine. Yeah, first battle, fellas. Everything went pretty damn well. We have some blind assisting damage. We have some blind damage, and if I'm not mistaken, we have some blind assisting damage. So this game is way over 5,000 combined and close to 4,000 damage dealt. Anyways, let's teleport into the round number 2, shall we? And we are back, fellas, in action. So what do we have? We have a T71 die with a very, very unusual play, I would say. I decided to go for a heavy line in the Maherm line. And Skill, why have you made this decision? I know it's very unpopular, but it can give you many, many benefits. If you would pay attention here, you would notice we are going to spot all heavy tanks crossing like this. And like I said before, I haven't fired many gold round clips with this tank, but this is one of the battles where I decided to go with a gold clip, right? I think this is only, if I'm not mistaken, this is pretty much only one game where I went with gold ammunition. Anyways, it is how it is. Everything is Gucci. To punish heavy tanks, we went for this strategy. But now, we are not even close for being done. We are going to make a hardcore pressure like this. We are going to cross through the field or through the, I don't even know, water, whatever. And we are going to make a humongous crossfire for the enemies. And this is what I am looking for, and this is what I am aiming for. And Skill, I have a question. Why you are not shooting gold ammunition with this tank, or why you wasn't shooting gold ammunition with this tank? Because it's expensive, that's why. So, standard penetration is more than enough in majority of the games, fellas, that's why. And with whenever you are completing crossing like this, enemies cannot do absolutely anything for you. This is it. This is game over. At this point, whenever you are crossing like this, fellas, you know pretty much you have won the game, and you are going to provide your team with a great assisting damage and with a great fire support. And this is what T71 is extremely good at. It doesn't matter what kind of map you are getting, even whenever you are getting Himmelsdorf or Ansk or whatever else, you can have a very, very nice performance with this tank just because you have autoloader. And it works 100% great, at least for me. And look at this beauty. We are spotting the Stunner Emil, and all we are trying to do here is to punish this guy without even asking his name. And once again, Stuborn Emil will take one for the team, and obviously he is not going to enjoy himself. And I would easily say this decision what we have made in this game is easily the reason why we are having such an advantage in such an early game in a way, don't you think so? Anyways, look at this. All we need to do, we need to open our eyes and we need to punish enemies every single time whenever we have ability. Also, I almost forgot to mention this. This battle is one of the first games with this vehicle and I played with a stock tank. If you would pay attention at the alpha damage is only 115 millimeters of penetration. And for first 5 games, I played with a stock tank just to check it out how the things are looking like. Funny fact, this vehicle, right, after 100 games, pretty much this is my second best damage game I managed to do with this vehicle. This is quite funny thing if you would ask me, but this is how it works, and now I remember everything pretty damn well. By the way, marking this tank took for me like, not only playing with this tank, playing with other tanks as well, making a break and playing in the L server for some time, I think it took roughly 4 days. So this is not very, very quick marking session by any means, but this is how long it took and this is what we have. And considering this is a battle with a stock gun, this is kind of nuts if you would ask me. And I think T71 DA is way more powerful than majority of the people thinks. It is truly very, very powerful tank, fellas, and I definitely need to highlight this. Anyways, what we are doing, we are trying to punish enemy Arta. Enemy Jeff is running for his life. I'm trying to track him. Unfortunately, I'm failing to track him, and I failed to penetrate this guy. But oh well, what can you do? Everything is Gucci. We are feeling well. We have 2,200 damage. We have 600 assisting damage. And all we need to do, we need to wait until we are going to reload, and now obviously we want to eliminate enemy Arta from the game if we can. And as you can see, gun handling is saying, what you said to me? Nah, everything is fine. We are going for a reload, obviously, and we know enemy T71 DA should sit in the goal for one position. There is no other way. This gentleman, he should be there. And I am waiting a bit until our guys will come closer. And our guys are closer, plus Arta fired. So what I am thinking, look at this. I am instantly looking to the bush where I think enemy light tank is. And look at this beauty, fellas. I read him like open book and he is dead. Plus on top of that, we are getting a bit of the assisting damage, which is always nice and always welcome. And once again, this tank, remember, this tank is stock in this game, and still we played pretty damn well. Skill, why it took 101 games to get Mark of Excellence up to 100%? I can tell you one thing, fellas, it is not easy to mark this vehicle. Expectation values was like 2,600 to get 100%, so I needed to be very, very consistent. And consistency is the key, and sometimes it can be a problem to be consistent, especially whenever you are overestimating your powers. For example, you are going for a scout run, and unfortunately you are getting hit or something, right? Because probably the worst thing about this vehicle is the size. Size of this tank is pretty huge, and if you would pay attention at the cupola and turret, whenever you are playing on the ridge line, your cupola is pretty much all the time visible. But obviously it is not destroying this tank by any means. And I rated this tank as a good vehicle, and I am going to change the rating to epic. Because I think this tank just simply deserves it. It truly does. And now, fellas, last but not least game, the game where we had the most combined score, a lot of damage, a lot of assisting damage, or I supposed to say, a lot of assisting damage. So let's teleport into the game, shall we? And we are back, fellas. Prokhorovka. I mean, where else we can get more assisting damage than there? This map is like the best map in the world of tanks for any light tank, and it is just beautiful, fellas. So how the things are looking like, we are starting absolutely everything from the middle, and it looks like a beautiful game, right? Although, let's pay attention to our team, what our team is doing. Literally no one went into the middle apart us. And this is a problem, because Prokhorovka is in a way simple map to play. You need to have some sniper schnitzels here in the back, you need to have someone up, and you need to have someone in the middle. And this is kind of self-explanatory. From the middle you are shooting the hill, from the hill you are shooting the middle, so you are making nice crossfire, and from the second line or 1-2 line you are shooting everyone who is playing in the middle or 1-2 line. It is self-explanatory, quite simple map. But unfortunately in this kind of situation the things are not working that well, and I am trying to figure out where the flying F light tanks are spotting our team from, because this is very, very important thing. We need to counter enemy light tanks, because if we won't, it is going to be a big fat trouble. And at this point, whenever I am getting spotted pretty much somewhere here, there is two options. Either they have a light tank very, very close to us, or they have a light tank very close to us. So what am I trying to do? I am trying to counter this light tank. I am trying to make as much pressure as I physically and possibly can, and obviously after that I'm making a hard turn. And unfortunately, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, but we did not manage to spot absolutely anyone. So now I am considering my life choices. I am thinking, wait a second, if I am not getting spotted this way, whenever I'm going like this and I'm not spotting everyone, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. So pretty much light tank should be here, right? But you see, I am going up and going up and going up, and I'm not getting spotted. So that should mean enemy light tanks are not sitting here either, which is a weird thing. Plane! Do you really need to make sound when I'm doing recording? Excuse me! I apologize, fellas, for the sound, but nothing what I can change about this. Some kind of mother trucker is doing his job, okay, by flying all over the place, so nothing unusual. Anyways, what I decided to do, I decided to relocate completely here, and I decided to take this very important position. And how the things are looking like, we got hit by shit ton of HP, like, we got punished so damn hard, it's madness how hard we got punished. But look at the bright side, luckily we countered enemy light tank, and now the things are looking so much better. Although I lost 2/3 of my HP, but I know I need to do something about the light tanks. And as you can see, our 87 is getting hit as well. So what is my main thinking process at this point? I want to spot the last remaining light tank, VK2801105. We need to spot this guy, otherwise we are going to have quite a bit of troubles. E25 spotted, team! E25 is spotted. And luckily for us, our team had a great reaction and our team managed to punish this E25. That's great, that's absolutely amazing. And what am I going to do now? I decided to sit in the typical bush for some time. Hear me out, why? Because eventually this E25, either he will try to escape or either he will try to go into the bush like this. And if this gentleman is trying to go into the bush, we are definitely going to spot him. As you can see, we can see pretty much most of those bushes here. So it is not going to be easy for him to do anything, right? In other words, he is sitting in the deep shithole. And at this point, we need to be very, very patient. Any of stupidity from our side is going to bring us to get effed, and this is not what I am looking for, right? I am just sitting here. Although I am thinking, okay, maybe we can go for another scout run just to check out the things, because they have the light tank and obviously it is very, very annoying. But as you can see, I am not getting any use whatsoever from this light tank, and I obviously noticed only one way how we can do the things. We need to go into the bush and sit there once again, because from this bush we are covering pretty much everything. You see, remember when I said E25 will try to go in once again? He did, he got slaughtered, and luckily for us, we are not even getting spotted. Main reason being is because probably there was either a bush between me and him, or alternatively, he had no commander. Either way, I am not complaining. So once again, let's highlight this position and importance of this position. We are spotting everyone who is trying to make pressure like this, and we are spotting everyone who is trying to make pressure from the middle. So this is super duper hyper turbo important position for us, and we cannot abandon it. Plus on top of that, a light tank decided to be aggressive, and this is super duper hyper turbo good thing for us. We have 8 minutes on the timer, so that's great, and obviously I'm risking for the biscuit and trying to eliminate light tank from the game, and luckily we did so. So fellas, at this point we currently poke enemy eyes. Enemies have no eyes whatsoever, and we still have T25/2 on top of the hill, so we still have some kind of crossfire, and that's very, very good. But I cannot make pressure like this, and even though if I would make pressure like this, this is not going to be a great situation for us, and the main reason being is this Erhashem, he is our MVP. We are pretty much spotting for this Erhashem. And this is, if this Erhashem cannot support us here, and we know for a fact Khan Panzer, who hit us before, we know he's sitting there. So once again, patience is the key. Half of the game passed, and all we need to do, we need to wait. I know it is annoying, and a lot of people do not have patience, but if you don't have patience playing with light tank, it is not a very nice option for you. Now, pay attention right there. Enemy Arlo. He is making pressure, and once again, this is not a smart idea by him, and he said, I did my best. This is what light tank supposed to do, in my opinion. I mean, know where to sit, at what time, and who is supporting him. And in this kind of situation, we have plenty of support, and all we need to do, we need to wait until enemies will make a mistake. Obviously, our T25/2, eventually he's going to die. It is a matter of the time when this gentleman will die. And we cannot do absolutely anything about this, because looking into amount of the hit points, we have 266 HP, we are down to unshotable for many guys, and if we are going to go like this, if Bled Prince is yoloing for us, we are dead. If Progetto is yoloing for us, we are dead. If Azai is yoloing for us, we are dead. If Panther is going for us, we are dead. You get the point what I'm saying. The most important thing what I want to say is we need to be smart, and we cannot be silly gooses, because otherwise it is going to be very bad and this is going to be just simply no bueno. So once again, wait, patience. That's only one way how you can play the game. And now, we know our team lost the hill. What that means? That means enemies might and will approach us from the rail side. So, I am relocating to the different bush. I am checking out how much I can see and how much I can spot. And the main reason being, I am not playing too aggressively here because I won't have escape route. Here it is relatively simple, just push in front and I am simply gun, you know, they will never know I was there. But in the same time, if I will be a bit more in front, this is going to be very, very bad. And now, you see, our Ergashem Borshek, he is doing some heavy lifting. He is doing absolutely amazing and incredible job for us. So that's very, very nice, and I am proud of this gentleman. We have 5 minutes left into the battle, and our team is losing the game by 2 guns. So yeah, this is not ideal, fellas. And soon, I am going to make other decision, which is to go back to this bush here. And I think this is a mistake which I am going to do in this game. I have a feeling this is a mistake, because from this side right now, I am pretty much spotting everyone. Panther is making pressure. I am spotting the Panther. If someone else is making pressure, I'm spotting someone else. And I think this could be bad decision from my side. Let me know in the comment section down below, do you think I misplayed this game or not so much? Anyways, relax, take it easy, 4 minutes on the timer, we are feeling Gucci and we are doing as much things as we can do. Now, enemy Blade Prince is playing in the middle, and once again, my goal is to spot them every single time they are going to do something silly. And remember, when I played with this battle, when I played in this game, it is relatively simple for me to, you know, be patient. By saying this, I am reading the chat meanwhile while I'm streaming, and I am just having conversation with the people. So for me to sit in the bush, it is quite easy situation, and it is overall quite simple. And now, as you can see, fellas, I am starting to think, okay, this M4 Alpha 1, he relocated. What is the chance there is no one who is making pressure via kilo 6 line? So I decide to relocate and I am instantly getting spotted. This is not ideal situation for us, and I have no clue who actually managed to spot us, but it is a fact we are spotted. So what am I thinking about doing now? I am thinking about spotting obviously Blade Prince and other guys, but in the same time, I am very, very well aware of Echo 1 position, and as you can see, now we know who is spotting us. Enemy Progetto did spotted us. Unfortunately, I moved from that position and I cannot do absolutely anything about this at this point. I know enemy Arta might try to blind fire, and he did that already, so I need to be extra careful. And I decided to F off from here, at least for now, and I need to take a bit different position. I am taking different position because I know Khan Panzer eventually will start making pressure on us, and we need to somehow be safe in a way. And T-34-85 blah, 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 going through the middle, and this is a problem, and this is a humongous problem, fellas. Our main damage dealer Ergashem Borshek, we did not spotted the incoming tank in time, and he died. So I am blaming myself for this. So we do not really have the guns who can carry our big baboonish, but at this point, and this is very, very bad situation. Skill, what are you talking about? It's tier 7. You are completing light tank 15 mission. I know. But I know in the same time it could be so much better than it is now. 2 minutes on the timer and enemy started the invasion, right? I am trying to figure out what position I want to play in, and as you can see, we managed to spot Progetto and Khan Panzer. Luckily for us, obviously Khan Panzer is in the open field, so what we are doing, we are just simply clipping the living crap out of him. But in the same time, whenever I am thinking about this, I think I made a mistake by clipping the Khan Panzer. Because I could clip the Progetto, and probably Progetto would be would be dead at this point. And as you can see, fellas, we are kind of trapped next to the red line. Unfortunately, we cannot do too many things. This Progetto is currently spotting our team, right? And I cannot even do anything, because if I am going to make pressure like this, I am going to get killed by the Kahnpanzer. If I'm going to make pressure towards Progetto, I am going to get slaughtered as well. If I am going to shoot, I am going to get slaughtered as well. So yeah, unfortunate situation. We cannot win this game. That sucks, that's sad. 20 seconds on the timer, 19 seconds on the timer, 10 seconds on the timer. I'm thinking, what is the chance he's not going to spot me in time, but he did. And we lost the game in the last moment. Sucks to be me, I guess. Sucks to be me. Anyways, we did great job, but the game could be definitely better. Let's teleport into the scoreboard, what we did in those three games in total, right? Let's go. And we are back, fellas. So, the best battle damage-wise was in Malinovka. 3.7 thousand damage, 1.8 thousand assisting damage. And let's see the score. Ace, Sniper Schnitzel, Patrol Duty, High Caliber, Confederate, 3.7 thousand damage, 2.1 thousand assisting damage, 4 kills, 1.6 base experience, 2.1 thousand damage, like I said before, actually assisting damage, and we are getting 52,000 profits. Beautiful game, very, very nice. Second best battle with T71 DA, while being completely stuck by the damage, was the game in the Macherm line. Ace Vanker, High Caliber, 3.5 thousand damage, 1,000 assisting damage, 4 kills. Beautiful game, 1.5 base experience, 50,000 profits. And last but not least, we had an absolutely amazing game in the Prokhorovka, but unfortunately I think I misplayed there. I'm waiting for your comments down below. If you watch it till the end, you are a champion. And I think I made some mistakes here. That's the main reason why we are getting effed so hard in a way. Anyways, we got Ace. We have the third mark of excellence. Patrol Duty, 7,000 assisting damage, 1,000 damage dealt. And MVP from the enemy team is obviously Progetto and Kahnpanzer. Those two gentlemen, they did very, very great job, and they did absolutely everything properly. And I'm thinking maybe in the end I could clip the Progetto, so we would have a bit better situation instead of clipping Kahnpanzer. At least that's what I think. Anyways, we made 56,000 profits. That's great, but unfortunately it wasn't victory. Anyways, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you were very, very well entertained by today's video. I know light tanks are not for everyone, but I truly wanted to share this with you, and I think the T71 is a hidden gem, and I would highly, if you love light tanks, if you enjoy light tanks, test this tank out. You might find your new favorite vehicle to play with. And for now, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out for today. Peace.